Hey everyone, it's Craig Spartan. It's been a while. My real name of those that you know it is Adam. Sorry for the shaky camera and whatnot. Kind of doing this impromptu in the middle of a forest and just found a spot to sit and we're going to go from there. And it's been a beautiful, beautiful area here. And of course, I'm sitting right there on the Mississippi, actually, right in between Iowa and Wisconsin. It's just, the trees are just turning colors and it's just absolutely beautiful. I'll give you a quick look here if you want to take a peek at that. I mean, I'm kind of more of in a swamp right now, unfortunately. We've had a lot of rain, but it's still a gorgeous area and it's been fun more or less. I have not made a video for a while, and you guys know that. Ever since January, life is different. Life is completely different. And I hope you guys do understand that. I do still love you guys. I love the Halo community still. You are amazing. The stuff you guys did back in January and February with the 24-hour live stream, what 343 did, I want to say thank you. My family thanks you. I mean, they were just all just blown away by you guys and what you did as a community, as a whole, and across the world. It's just been absolutely amazing what you guys did. So I do say thank you to all of you for that. But today I wanted to talk to you about a little something that has happened since that incident. Now, if you don't know what the incident is, briefly, we had a tragedy in our family. Me and my wife, it's hard to talk about. It's even hard to say at this point. Even it's been how many months? It's been 9 months since, and it's still hard to talk about. Back in January, my wife and I, we went to work and unfortunately we came home and our house was on fire and everything was lost, including our two daughters. So yeah, that changes a man. That changes a lot. That changes your outlook on life. He said, it's hard to talk about, it's hard to think about. I mean, I still get flashbacks to that night, and that's just never ever going to go away. But this is not a pity party. This is something I wanted to talk about, because after this event, I questioned a lot of things. I mean, a lot of things. I mean, general in life, I questioned a lot, and I'd hope you guys listen to this. I went out on an all-out search for God. I did. I went an all-out search for God. I wanted to know for sure. I mean, I was always a believer. I always kind of believed, but it's a little different in that I was just kind of, for lack of a better term, I just like lackadaisical. You know, I believed, yeah. You know, I went to church on occasion. I believe that Christ lived and died for us on the sins. But it's different now. Because when I did that, when I went, because I questioned absolutely everything. I did. I questioned everything. I questioned my faith. I questioned whether or not it was real. I questioned, because when you lose what we lost, you have to think, what happened? What, how is that even possible? And so I went out on a quest, basically, and I found a lot of different things. Number one, and this is the most important thing, I'm going to start off right there. This is the most important thing that you're going to hear from me. Is number one, is God is 100% real. 100%. This is not a question to me anymore. I know for a fact that God is real. God is with us. God is part of us. God sustains us in every way. Even for those, for all of us, considering what we do in this life, God sustains this planet and our everything still. So how did I come to that conclusion? To be honest, the first thing I did was I wanted to look for scientific proof that God was real. And that was a quest in itself. But what I kept finding over and over and over and over and over again is that the proof is there. We just have to look. We have to want to look. We have to want to see it. I found, and I'm just going to give you one or two examples here real quick, and these are basic summarizations here. One of the things I found out is that, our planet was formed and how the universe was formed and everything else. Over the course of time, scientists have developed the Big Bang Theory, which is pretty much everybody knows about the Big Bang Theory, of course, with the show and everything. It's probably people think about that, and the honest truth, though, is, and this is what's amazing, this is what is absolutely amazing, is how they describe the Big Bang Theory all the way up to the creation of man is accurate. There is actually about 13 points, and I'm not going to go into each and every single one of them, but about 13 points that scientists say had to happen before we could walk on this planet. They had to happen. The interesting thing is that the Bible actually has all 13 points in a row. And this was back in, this was written by Moses, which was a long time ago, and they didn't have scientific equipment. They didn't even have telescopes. So let me ask you how they knew how that happened. Completely accurate. Even according to scientists today, they're amazed by that fact. What else here? Talk about the 10 plagues of Egypt. If you guys know of Exodus and whatnot, Moses went into Egypt, and his basic summarization, and basically said these 10 plagues are going to happen. And the funny thing is about that too, is scientists have studied that, and they're not quite sure on the exact cause, because God works with what he has here, and so they don't know if it's a volcano or if it was algae or anything else like that. But the first plague was the river turning to blood. Now, I don't think it was actual blood, but it was really blood red, which actually has happened recently. If you look it up, I think it was the Dead Sea. I can't remember. That actually turned blood red just recently. So that it does happen. And then what they discovered is that every single plague happened in the exact order it should have happened, because they looked as well, if that caused that, then the frogs would leave the river, and then of course the river would the frogs would die because they would be, it's a whole line of stuff, but they've actually found out is yes, this is very, very plausible that this would have happened in this exact order and everything. Even all the way down to the firstborn's deaths, because one of the things that the Egyptians did was they would, of course, have sacrifices and stuff like that. And to appease their god, they would do that. They would sacrifice their firstborn. So yes, it has been proven time and time again. And that's just two examples. And there's far more, especially with prophecy, especially today with prophecy and what's happening. The book of Hosea says that, during the last days and whatnot, the birds and the fish and whatever, they're just going to die, just outright die out of the air. And that's been happening all over the place. So, yeah, the Bible is very, very, very real. What's written there is very real. I just hope you guys truly understand that. I don't talk about this lightly, and to put myself out like this is something else, because, you know, people are going to be non-believers, and they're going to be saying what they say, and they're going to say I have a made-up friend. I know what they say. Trust me, I know what they say, but I also feel bad for them. So I am definitely going to be posting links down below to a few videos that I think you guys would probably like to watch. I do hope you take the time to watch them, because this stuff can't happen without the power of God. It just can't. So I did want to talk to you guys about that. I mean, when you watch the other videos, I do hope you do, just take the time and just watch them. See what God does when He's moving with the people of the planet, and they have the faith and they have the belief. God can do amazing things. I mean, stuff that you wouldn't even think was possible, which is awesome. So that's what's been going on. And I want to say a few other things here, and that's, I am not perfect. As you guys know, especially those that know me personally, I'm definitely not perfect. But God forgives me of what I've done. And I've done a lot. I've done a lot of stupid things in my life. But God does forgive. He forgives everything. All you have to do is believe and ask for it. And I mean, like I said, that is just an absolutely amazing thing. You want to think about it. The things I've done, when you watch this video, are the links. I haven't done absolutely everything there. I have prayed for people. And the amazing thing is, like I said, this is why I know this is 100% real. Is, I've prayed for people and they just, it's kind of hard to describe, but they felt the presence of God and they just got freaked out. I'm serious. They felt the presence of God. I mean, it wasn't like a crazy prayer or anything. All it just said is, God, hey, let them feel your presence right now. And it was just amazing. I mean, they literally would like freak out, and they couldn't explain what they felt and how it happened and everything. So, like I said, that's amazing. God is amazing. So, like I said, guys, I want to say thank you to absolutely everybody that helped my family, and of course those that have sent prayers. I do appreciate that so much. And of course my family and everything else. We've been through so much, and the thought, and that's why I hope you guys take this as to what I'm saying is seriously, was we have been through more than I think anybody can possibly imagine. Of course, with my wife and I being in the military, and then after that, of course, our family and moving, and then, of course, this tragedy. We've been through a lot, and our faith has kept us alive, and I do mean that literally. Our faith has kept us alive. So, if you are interested in this kind of faith, this kind of power, this living God, you want Him in your life, I am going to ask and I'm going to pray. I'm going to say this to you guys. This is just do a simple prayer. And for those that do not, I'm going to say this first, that don't know. They don't know. It's like, yeah, I don't know if God is real. Well, this is another simple prayer, and God proves it. God will prove it to you. Just say, Lord, I don't know if you're real or not, but if you are, show yourself to me. Reveal yourself to me in some way. It's a simple prayer. God will show Himself. God will. I've seen Him do it. It might be kind of random. You might think it's kind of random, but it's not. And then, after you have that experience, if you do that, just do another very, very simple prayer. And it's so simple. All you have to do is go like this. Heavenly Father, I am a sinner. Forgive my sins. And I ask you to come into my life right now in Jesus' name. Fill my heart. Fill my soul with your presence in Jesus' name right now. Amen. That's it, guys. That's it. He asks to come into your life. You don't have to. It's a choice. That's always been a choice. But when you do, wow. That's all I can tell you, is wow. I mean, like I said, I hope you consider what me and my wife have been through. And my faith is like this. My faith has grown exponentially. So Father, I want to pray one more prayer. I want to pray for anybody that's watching this video right now. I pray, God, that you show yourself to them. In Jesus' name, I pray right now. Amen. So, well, guys, I do thank you for listening to me, taking the time to watch this video. And it's kind of long, but I think it's important. And if you have prayed that prayer today, we'll see about finding you some steps or some places to go. There are some videos, of course, I can show you, and hopefully places or people in your area that can help you get started on your walk with Christ, because it's going to be amazing, guys. There is no doubt in my mind, it is going to be amazing. It doesn't matter what you've done, Christ wants you to come home. That's it. Christ wants you to come home. All right, guys, I'm going to let you go. Thanks for watching. This is the Crazy Spartan. I'm out of here.